Live, local, breaking news. This is WYFF News 4 at 6 in high definition.
Well, the governor officially put out the welcome mat today for an Illinois-based company bringing new jobs to the upstate. Good evening. Welcome. I'm Michael Cogdell.
And I'm Gabrielle Komorowski in tonight for Carol. The plan was known as Project Mustang, a $22 million investment in Anderson County with the promise of 250 new jobs.
Well, tonight we know the company is McLaughlin Body Company. The News 4's Myra Ruiz is live and local in Anderson County tonight. Myra, a lot of folks are going to want to know, when does the hiring start?
The McLaughlin Body Company of Moline, Illinois, says the hiring process will start in 2 to 3 months. And this is where the company plans to locate in Anderson County. It's in the old Sand Hens of America plant. You may recall it shut down about 6 years ago, taking away about 250 jobs. And it turns out that's just how many MBC plans to bring here over a five-year period.
Nervous. McLaughlin Body Company has decided to pick South Carolina when they could have picked any place else. They decided to come here to Anderson County.
Governor Nikki Haley says that decision was partly based on the state's commitment to family-owned businesses and the absence of unions.
It's not about getting a company here. It's about making sure that after they've been here a year, they say this was the best decision they ever made.
Company owner Tom McLaughlin says Anderson County is also close to existing customers.
It's going to be a perfect fit, and we're going to be great neighbors.
The company mostly makes cab enclosures for the agriculture, military, and construction businesses. MBC will locate in the old Sand Hens plant and hire welders, trimmers, painters, and robotic technicians, making room for manufacturing jobs once again.
So we've seen a great resurgence, if you will, but the demand is for people that have skill sets, not just people that can show up and do what they're told, but people that can think and again operate very sophisticated equipment.
Tri-County Tech's new Industrial Technology Center will prepare future MBC employees.
We'll be doing some training with new employees who've had no experience and with employees who have potential experience, but trying to get them to focus on the way this new company does work.
We want to welcome you to the South Carolina team. Know that we are absolutely committed to your success and look forward to working with you.
The company plans to be fully operational here within the early first 3 months of 2014 and having about 150 new jobs here within the first year. Myra Ruiz, WYFF News 4, live in Anderson County.
All right, thank you, Myra. Investigators tonight have made an arrest in a weekend shooting that took a teenager's life at a birthday party. This happened in Greenwood on Saturday near Tabor Street. Officers say five people were shot as the party was going on, including 15-year-old Malik Paget. He died later at a hospital. The other four survived. Police have now arrested 17-year-old Deterius White. Tonight they charge him with murder.
A woman called 911 from a moving car this morning to report that she was being kidnapped. That sparked a high-speed chase in Newberry County. It went through the downtown area, then into Saluda before the chase ended and the suspect was arrested. And tonight we are learning more about the Greenville connection to the case. News 4's Angela Rodriguez has the latest tonight from Newberry County.
Investigators tell us the suspect and the victim spent the weekend in Greenville soliciting donations. The woman held against her will says that the trouble started when she told the suspect she wanted to go back home to Georgia. And tonight, for the first time, we're hearing part of the 911 call that she made from inside that car. Newberry County deputies say that frantic 911 call just before 7:30 this morning from a woman claiming to be abducted led to a high-speed chase that at times exceeded 100 miles per hour. The suspect finally surrendered about 40 minutes later in Saluda County after all of his tires were flattened by law enforcement.
She felt that day, this day, when she tried to get away from him, that he had intentions of killing her.
The suspect, Henry Davis, is now charged with kidnapping, battery, driving under a suspended license, and failing to stop for law enforcement. Investigators say Davis hired the victim on Friday to help him solicit donations for his organization, Operation Child Search and Rescue. Davis told a dispatcher the woman tried to kill him. This is part of the 911 call shortly before his arrest. Investigators do not believe Davis's story. Tonight he's still being held at the Newberry County Detention Center, and more charges are expected because Davis is also accused of ramming his car into a trooper's car during that high-speed chase this morning. And investigators say that Davis has a lengthy criminal past, including charges of sexual assault and armed robbery.
Angela Rodriguez, WYFF News 4, Newberry County.
All right, Angela, thank you. The woman whose baby was left abandoned outside a home in Anderson is still in Georgia tonight. That's where she lives. Tongila McBride and Alonzo Brown are charged with unlawful neglect of a child in this case. They were arrested on Saturday. McBride was taken into custody in Georgia. Brown, the little girl's father, was arrested here in the upstate. Deputies say the couple's four-year-old little girl, Zoe Brown, was found on the front porch of a home on Brook Forest Drive last Tuesday night. You may remember that. Right now, we're waiting for word on when authorities will bring Tongila McBride back to Anderson to face the charge.
Meanwhile, also in Anderson County, a mother left her baby behind today. The newborn was surrendered at Ann Med. We're told a woman walked into the hospital and stated that she wanted to surrender the two-day-old child. Officials have turned custody over to DSS. Now, this surrender does fall under what is called Daniel's Law. That allows a guardian to leave a child at a safe haven like a hospital, church, or fire station without being prosecuted.
We're covering a bizarre case involving a man and a child in Greenville County tonight. Deputies say they found the man carrying a baby and walking into traffic on Highway 25. They tell us both the man and the child were naked. This is 24-year-old Anthony Michael Hedger. Deputies arrested him near Highway 414. And deputies say the child is his 13-month-old son. They also say as they tried to take the baby, Hedger bit the child on the shoulder. Tonight he is charged with unlawful conduct toward a child.
A woman impersonating a DSS worker was taken to jail. Investigators say she was trying to steal prescription medication. Christy DeYoung was arrested yesterday in Greenville. Police say she went door-to-door at Towers East Apartments in Greenville. Officers said DeYoung asked the people there about their living conditions and asked to check on their medications. One of the victims called 911. DeYoung is charged with possession of a controlled substance and impersonation of an officer to secure property.
This is the season when one of the biggest sporting events in all of sports has an impact on our part of the world. And this year you will find two upstate golfers competing in the Masters. We also find News 4 Sports Director Brad Fralick in Augusta tonight. And this time talking a Clemson man named Lucas Glover.
Former Clemson All-American Lucas Glover is making his sixth appearance here at the Masters, and this is Glover's first major test as he tries to rebound from a forgettable 2012.
Oh, beautiful play. Really good. Well, that didn't stop. He's going to hold him away.
Greenville's Lucas Glover has walked golf's gauntlet, playing from the highest of highs to the lowest of lows.
Lucas Glover loves New York.
4 years ago, Glover climbed the major championship mountain, winning the U.S. Open.
That's one fortunate thing I have going for me is I can draw on that the whole rest of my life.
But his career bottomed out just 3 years later. Injuries cost him most of the 2012 season.
It was a tough year, but made some changes, and I think they're for the better. Got my knee fixed and 110% there. And I'm working on some new stuff. I feel like it's the right stuff. Saw some progress at Honda with a good finish.
The season's strong start has Glover looking forward to the season's first major.
Re-energized, remarried, refocused.
A couple weeks struggled coming into here, but had a good week off last week. Feel like my prep was good. And hard not to be excited when you get to Augusta.
Lucas Glover could be one of this week's biggest wild cards. And while Glover has proven he can perform on some of golf's toughest tracks, he hasn't been able to prove it here at Augusta National. Glover has not made the cut here at the Masters in 3 years. In Augusta, Brad Fralick, WYFF, News 4 Sports.
There is plenty to come. News 4's Mike Giordano will have more on the Masters in just a bit, coming up here in sports. A four-year-old boy ended up bitten several times by a stray dog. His family had tried to help.
News 4's Mike McCormick now with why there is a lesson in this for all of us.
This dog is under quarantine at the Spartanburg Humane Society to see if it shows signs of rabies. That's mandatory procedure after something like this happens.
The dog beat me.
Four-year-old Jackson ended up with the puncture wounds and scratches on Sunday.
I was inside cooking, and this one ran around and was just trying to pet the dog, and the dog bit him.
Jackson's mom, Notoria Foster, says the mixed breed was a stray that spent the last week or so running around her neighborhood in Spartanburg.
And I was going to try to find him a home. I kind of felt bad for him, so I put him over there in my mother-in-law's fence. And when my brother-in-law and sister-in-law went to move in, the dog jumped up on him and then darted out.
They caught the dog and tied it to the tree in their backyard. They even gave it a nickname, Pepper.
It's okay. It's all right. I ain't gonna mess with it.
After it bit Jackson, Spartanburg Animal Services took the dog.
But you never know just exactly how the